Hi, this is our waterproof LED marine strobe. It can be used for a variety of sports, from kayaking to diving, and a variety of uses, from the obvious emergency signalling to marking a location to return to if you're diving. It has a single switch here that puts it on, and it emits a pulsed strobe light effect. So it has six pulses of light and it puts out 30 of them every minute. It's quite a bright light. It's not perfectly obvious here in the bright conditions, but I will show you that in the dark later on. We've got four LED lights, three around here and one in the top. So the light it emits is 360 degrees right the way around. But on the top here, we've also got a focused beam of light. Now that comes in useful for if you are in an emergency situation and you're trying to attract attention to someone who perhaps might be rescuing you or trying to find you. You can help steer them towards you by aiming the more focused beam of light. If I put that against my shirt here, you can see the circular pattern. It's a more cone shape that comes out of this end of the strobe, where if you know someone in that direction is coming towards you, you can help them see you by focusing the light there. But for more general use, if you're stranded for a long period of time and you want a general signal of your location, you would probably use it that way, where you get the 360 degree emission of the light. You can wear it on your arm. It comes with a strap. If you want to wear it in your arm, the way I find easiest is to put it in like this, and then reach for the sky whilst strapping it up, and it falls in position. Then you can just simply put it on. There's quite a lot of strap there. That's what's extra on my bare arm, so there's enough to wear over a wetsuit, for example. And when it's in position, you know, it's quite sturdy, you know. So you could paddle, you know, you could swim, you know, you could stand up paddleboard. You can continue doing your activity with that in place, or you can just float with it in place, you know. The strap's totally removable. It just pulls through, and that leaves you with some other mounting options. We've got a bar here and a bar here that the strap went through. You can put your own webbing through that, your own webbing strap, if you wanted to fix it to a kayak, a boat, or your diving equipment, mount it on your BCD. It's also got a little wrist lanyard that if you're just carrying it, you know, it'll dangle, or you know, extra security if you're holding it should it fall. That can also be removed if you don't need it, and there's a little hole here that the lanyard goes through that you could put your own cord through if you've got a different requirement. The top unscrews to reveal the light capsule. You can see it's not old-fashioned LEDs we're using anymore. It's what's called surface mount LEDs, so they're little square yellow blobs, and each one of them is quite a high efficiency LED, putting out 50 lumens each, so there's 200 lumens coming out of that little capsule in total. They're half watt LEDs. The capsule sits inside the dome, and there's a little O-ring that sits around the capsule that helps keep water out. Now there's double O-rings in here just to be certain. There's another O-ring just in here that should that fail, the second one will capture it. So it's really quite a watertight construction. Inside we have the battery capsule. So you put three AA batteries in here and then simply drop it back in. The little switch that's on here is a magnetic switch, so it's not like a regular switch where if I move this it would directly open and close some contacts. If that was a regular switch, it would be prone to water getting into the switch. This is a magnetic switch, and when you move the switch up and down, it simply moves a magnet up and down. That magnetic field goes through the casing to the inside and a little magnetic reed switch operates inside the casing to switch the torch on and off. So there's no chance of the water getting into the electrical components of this torch because it's a magnetic tight switch. Put it back together. It's probably easiest done horizontally. That stops everything falling around. And when you're tightening it, you don't want to over tighten it. So when it stops, just get a little bit further than when it stops, and that's enough. Battery life on this, I would expect this still to be flashing about a week after you set it going. And as the battery reduces in its charge, this doesn't just suddenly stop working. It reduces over a period, then it tails off. So even after a week, you'll still have a degree of usable light, although it won't be as bright as it initially is. At full brightness, you know, after 3 to 4 days, it's still going to be going strong at pretty much full brightness. And as you get into day 5, 6, depending on the battery type and brand, it's still going to be usable, but it's going to start tailing off. Like any piece of safety equipment, test it regularly. You know, don't put this in your boat and then a year later, not having looked at it since, need it in anger. The batteries might have failed. It might have been damaged. So, you know, flicking it on for 10 seconds every time you go out isn't going to drain the battery significantly. So test it and every other piece of kit you're going to rely on regularly so you're certain, A, you know how it works, and B, that you know it actually still is in serviceable condition. If you're a diver and want to use it, it's watertight down to 80 metres, which is deeper than the most recreational diving, obviously. And you can use it either in an emergency to attract attention, you can use that underwater to attract your buddies or dive group towards you. You can use it to mark a location to return to meet at, or you can simply keep it for surface use when you return to the surface. If you become distanced from your boat, you can use it as an aid to that or anyone else who is coming to your assistance. And that's our LED marine stroke.